every organ in the body really has two different roles. It has a job to do, and then it has to communicate with the rest of the body. Take muscle, for example. It causes bones to move. Your brain thinks. And fat, its job is to store calories. And this is what a cluster of white fat cells look like when magnified using a standard microscopic image. And this is what a cluster of white fat cells looks like using a very high-power electron microscope. But fat also needs to tell the rest of the body what's going on. How much fat is in the fat that it's storing? How much energy is there? And do you need to eat more or should you eat less? And that's where the hormones come in. Hormones are small chemicals that are released into the blood by an organ such as fat and then go around and tell them other parts of the body what to do. So for example, leptin, which is a hormone that was discovered roughly 20 years ago, goes to the brain and tells the brain this is how many calories currently are here. And if there aren't enough, then you should eat more and you should conserve the number of calories that you're expending through maintaining your heat. And if you've eaten too much, then leptin goes to the brain and says, all right, that's enough. Adiponectin is another hormone that's released by fat. And that hormone goes to other parts of the body, such as liver and muscle, and causes glucose and fats to be consumed. And that's usually a beneficial thing for the body. But fat can also, if there's too much fat, this is 5 pounds, imagine in another 15 pounds of this stuff. If there's more fat, then it releases what we call hormones or cytokines, which change in concentration dramatically in the blood. And they can cause insulin resistance, in which case the insulin that the pancreas makes, which is a hormone from there, it causes the insulin to work worse. Glucose stays in the blood rather than being taken up by the muscle and the liver and the fat and the other organs. And it can release other cytokines like IL-6, which can cause increased inflammation, which can predispose you to things like blood clots and can make gallstones potentially more worse and do many other things that we don't want to see. So fat is not just the storage of calories, it's actually the release of hormones and cytokines into the blood that tell the body what's going on and can be both beneficial and hurtful. And it's the job of the endocrinologist and scientist to find a way to help a person become healthier.